Okay, so we are on day four. And so what we're doing is we're taking that differential equation, that slope field equation, so to speak, and we're separating the variables. And so if we have, this can't always be done, but and it's a little beyond the scope of this class, but sometimes we can't separate the variables. Sometimes we can't get all the X variables on one side and all the Y variables on the other side. But when we can do that, it's called a separable differential equation. And separable differential equations can be then integrated and solved. So what we're literally doing is we're finding antiderivatives. And so the interesting thing is when you separate the variables, sometimes you end up with like running out of space. Holy cow. Sometimes you end up with like y squared dy equals 1 over x dx, and you have to integrate both sides. And of course, we don't have limits of integration during this process, so it's really an antiderivative. And so when we have, when we find the antiderivative and we put our c on the end, and we find our antiderivative and put a c on the end, those two values might be different. They probably won't be the same. So they're distinct values, but in all reality, we can always subtract the constant on the y and put it over on the x side and just get a new number. Does that make sense? Because they're just constants. So that's why we don't even address a constant on the y side, because usually we solve for y anyway. So we just drop the constant on the y side and just put it on the x side. And then this represents both of those constants of integration. And we just don't really worry too much about it. It all works out because we usually want to solve for y. So we usually end up multiplying by 3 and taking the 1/3 power anyway for this example. And so the constant will work itself out. We just put the plus c on the x side. That's what this is speaking to. So really, when we're talking about that general form, after we solve for the differential equation, it's that's the equivalent of finding the antiderivative. And so those two are like one and the same. And remember, this is because it's a general form, because it has this example here, because it has the plus c at the end, it represents a family of functions, right? X squared plus c represents all our parabolas with different intercepts. And all of those have the same derivative. So it represents a family of this in particular represents a family of quadratics, or the quadratic family, however you want to say that. And the quadratic family, all of them have this derivative, as long as the coefficient out here is one. So they all have the same curvature, so to speak. So any questions about that? All right, so we're really literally doing an antiderivative process. So what is a general solution? It is an antiderivative, and it represents a family of functions. So we've got topic questions today. Or just a comment, separate variables, anti-differentiate both sides, solve for y. So it's kind of like the steps there to get the general solution. And no unit 7, day 5 notes. Oh yeah, we're doing corrections tomorrow. That's why. Okay. So no notes for tonight. And then you've got 3 cons after you get done with those topic questions. So any question? All right, let's crank those out. And I'll be around to check in notes and touch base with you to see how you're doing. I just had to like keep moving my maybe like change my path. We're not sure what's happening, but we get in after a while. You know, like, anybody else having problems with plugging the power cord? Apparently they're redoing the system or something, I don't know.